take a step back. Cause it's only a setback. Is this your last time too?
No, I just put it in.
Yeah, I don't remember it.
I just put it in as well.
But how many kids do you train here? Or train at the gym actually?
Yeah, like kids.
I know it. Boxing's popular.
40 kids.
Yeah. Indio's the hood, people don't know.
Yeah, actually we are in the hood. These complexes here. It's an apartment called Summerfields, formerly known as Maker Vineyards. A lot of killings here. A lot of killings.
It's a shame.
Back in talking about 10 years ago. Every morning, a body here, a body
wow.
over there, a body over there, a body over here.
You know, they shot at Adrian Broner last night. Eight bullets. Didn't hit him. It hit his car. Eight bullets.
So
terrible.
I heard he got arrested for driving a shot of a truck.
Yeah, but that's not, it's not his fault someone shot at you. That's really stupid. But I'm glad he's okay. He's a good dude, man.
Yeah, he's a good guy. I mean, he does a lot of crazy stuff, but he's a good guy.
Hey, he's young. All right, coach. All right. We'll see you soon.
Take care.
Go watch the fights tonight. See how Mikey Perez against your brother. Stay tuned. FiestusReport.com. I'm Ali Sekbek reporting. The history. Oscar's a promoter and Biop's still fighting. No, just retired. Sorry.
And they're associated.
Klitschko Williams. Are these all local paper clippings?
Yes, sir. See what he did about Cub Swanson when he fought Jose Aldo.
Wow.
Got a knee right in the
forehead. That's like Klitschko when he fought.
That's Cub? Right
yeah,
there?
Yeah.
Who did Klitschko fight at Staples Center? Lennox Lewis had the same kind of cut and they stopped the fight, even though Klitschko was winning.
Yeah, but Klitschko's was.
He had a broken orbital bone.
Oh, shit. And did he win the fight? Yeah. What's the history of this picture?
I don't know. I found this picture on the web and I thought it was funny, so I printed it out.
When you lost Marquez.
I tell people, hey, they asked me, what's up with the picture? I go, Freddie Roach went to the Philippines looking for talent. He found a kid by the river with the trees. He told the kid, come on, make a world champion. And that's how I started with him. See, I have this kid right now, little Caden Griffith, Triple T. Big fan of Triple G. So notice every time he fights,
he does the same thing.
Same thing.
What did you think of Triple G's last fight, Antonio?
You know what? I thought it was a close fight. I thought it was my thinking is it was a close fight.
That's Felix Diaz gloves.
I think he won the fight. I think he won the fight by a round or two. I just think he did that to put on the Canelo head. Oh, I could beat him.
I'm perfect. So give Canelo the lead to jump in. It's possible, but that's two fights in a row he didn't shine.
You know, the story behind that fight was when I had Diego, Cameron was supposed to let me train Julio.
Oh, you.
Your brother.
What?
And he said, oh, yeah, I got to take you to see who, this other kid that got Julio. And like fight after fight, no, not yet. And finally I was like, fuck you then. And Diego had went to jail and he had just knocked out Manfredi. My friend called me like a year later, maybe 6 months or whatever, a year later, and I was like, fuck it, dude, he's not gonna fucking use me. So I went to my friend, and that was our first.
So we're together?
Yeah, that was what the fuck? You know, it's funny because I was supposed to come here. Like forever, he kept bringing it up. Oh, I got this kid I want you to work with. I got this kid.
Is Cub the only UFC star that's here right now?
Yeah.
What's that? Who gave birth? Lee?
That's me right there.
I know, but that's Lee Espinosa.
See, the thing is this. When Lucas Matisse came here the first time when he fought Danny Garcia, one of my friends, he made a picture of his trainer. It's a short, red-headed guy, and he put Canelo on his hands, and he goes, "Hey, Canelo, I'm your papa."
Uh-huh.
So I had it right here, and then one of my buddies who's Argentinian, he goes, "Hey, I'll give you $100 if you do one of Lee with Toño."
Wow.
Because Lee was my trainer. He started me when I was 8 years old, and he showed me everything. Yeah, he's the one that he was my trainer, Joel's trainer, Julio's trainer.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Lee Espinosa. So Lee was right here. He came to see Matisse, and we asked Lee, holding hands like this. So he did. He took a picture. So my buddy Wayne got me a picture of me, and he posted that one like that. And he brought it to me. My buddy gave him $100.
He has one of the nicest gyms. I've been there. He has a sauna.
Oh, Lee has a great
gym. Yeah, it's huge.
I mean, it's...
It's spread like out, yeah.
Two, 3 times bigger than this.
Yeah.
Where, here?
Down
the street. Not far.
Oh, really?
Yeah, well, he has a, you walk in, it's a boxing ring, then it has another room on the side, which is open, there's another boxing ring, he has a punching bags, And you go to the back, it has a lot of
weights. Weights and a sauna in the corner. Like,
and has sauna.
There's a golf tournament here. I don't know if it exists anymore.
They do it at the Valley Box.
And they donate to him. Yeah, Bob Hope. They would donate to him thousands and thousands of dollars every year from the golf tournament to the gym.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram at Eli Sekpak.